Today I passed the CompTIA Security Plus 701 exam, and in this video I'll be sharing the requirements of the exam, the tips and tricks I used, how long it took me to pass the exam, and most importantly, what you can do to pass the exam on the first try and to be able to compress the time that it takes you to pass the exam. Come with me. One thing that you have to understand is that passing the CompTIA exams is great, but more importantly, understanding and not cramming is better. What you can do the day before the exam and on the exam day. Also, be sure to watch till the end where I summarize and condense all the concepts that you can use to pass quickly. Before I introduce myself, I want to let you know that from personal experience, I believe that the CompTIA 701 exam is a lot easier than the CompTIA 601 exam because of mainly most of the networking part of the exam has been removed and they've focused the exam into more of a security base. So they've taken the networking part out and now you can just go directly into the security. My name is Tunde Malomo. I've worked in the banking industry for 18 years. Most of my cybersecurity function in the banking industry has revolved around business operational risk management and control. So it would be like the GRC function of security. I've been in the banking industry, investment banking, but I specialize in risk and control. A brief overview of the CompTIA Security Plus exam is that you can get up to 90 questions. I got 76 questions during my exam. It will take up to 90 minutes to finish the exams. It's a mixture of PBQ questions, they call it the performance-based questions, and multiple choice questions. I got 3 performance-based questions. My advice to you for the performance-based questions is to skip these questions entirely to the end when you are finished with all other questions. Why? For me, I believe that I probably got all the performance-based questions wrong and I still performed very well in the exams. I just didn't quite understand what CompTIA was saying. However, some people are saying that you get partial credit for the performance-based exam. But the best thing is to move them to the end. The grading scale for the CompTIA exam is between 100 and 900 points. So if you get to the exam and you just put your name down and just sit there and don't answer any questions, you're going to get 100 points. And the most you can get by solving all the questions is 900 points. There are 5 domains of the exams and they are measuring 28 objectives in all. Now, the domains are general security concepts. That will give you 12% of the exam. Threats, vulnerabilities, and mitigations is 22%. Security architecture, that's 18%. Security operations, that's 28%. And the fifth and final is security program management and oversight. When you add all this up, it gives you 100 points. Let's talk about the study plan or study strategy. Everybody, they have their own study strategy and how they plan to attack the question. This is what I used. I studied for 8 weeks. I studied when I was working full-time. So I have a full-time work. So I woke up between 5 and 6 o'clock in the morning and I spent the first 2 hours to study for the exam. I usually do this for about 3 to 4 times a week. Now, for me, the most optimal time is studying before everybody in my home wakes up. So I use that first 2 hours to just study. And that is what has worked for me. The next thing is the study resource. What do you intend to use and how do you want to go about it? The most damaging part of studying for the CompTIA Security Plus exam is the sheer amount of resources and information that you have out there. There are too many resources. And when there are too many resources, you get into this spiral of information overload. I believe this information overload can take you or set you back months. The best thing is to decide what you're going to use and how you're going to use it. You have video information, especially on YouTube. You have Professor Mesa, you have Jason Dion. You have so many people on YouTube giving you their 2 cents on how to do the exam. And you have online resources like Udemy and StudySat and all these resources that if you don't decide how you want to attack the CompTIA Security Plus exam, you will find yourself going through many resources and you are coming back to the same spot that you think that you don't know enough. What I will tell you from my own case is that even if I'd taken the exam 4 weeks earlier, I will have probably passed. Why? Because I understood the basic concept of the exam. And once you understand the basic concept of the exam, you are likely to pass it because they are asking for practical questions. They are not having you memorize concept. Once you have a good idea, you can go for the exam and pass. So what I used was that I used a combination of the video resources and also the books and Udemy. I was studying for the CompTIA 601 exam. So I got this book. It's Daryl Gibson, Security Plus, Get Certified, Get Ahead. Then when I found out that I was going to eventually take the 701 exam, I went to get another one, which is for Ian Neal, Master Cybersecurity Fundamentals, and pass the SYO 701 exam on your first try. Now, these books, they gave me a guide on how to attack the exam. The 701 by Ian Neal, it has 28 chapters that dealt with each objective. And you can just use that as a guide. At the end of each chapter, they have 10 questions that you can go through. It also has exam study online that when you want to take the exam, you can go online and you have resources that you can use. On the video courses, I used Professor Messer. I didn't watch all the YouTube videos. Maybe when I'm going for a walk, I just put on my headphones and I just listen to Professor Messer just to hear what he says about each section. Udemy is another resource that you can use, and there are several teachers on Udemy. A very popular one is Jason Dion, which I bought the course. I bought it when it was 601 and he revamped it on the 701, and it's a lengthy course. It's about 20 hours. What you can do is to look for the, if you have 20 hours to study everything, by all means, knock yourself out and actually do that. But if you don't, you might just want to take a pre-assessment test and gauge which areas that you need help in and go a little bit further in that area. Jason Dion's exam questions, what he wants is for you to score a 90%. But even if you are scoring 65 or 70%, I believe that you are going to be fine. The reason Jason Dion have 90% as the pass score is because of the guarantee that he has that if you score 90% and you fail the exam, he's going to give you your money back. And obviously, he doesn't want to give you your money back. So even if you score like a 70% on Jason Dion exam, you will be fine. You can go take the exam. When you want to take the practice test, my recommendations for you will be to use the ANL online practice test. You get 3 complete practice tests and 280 questions from a textbook. That is the physical test. The last one is Daryl Gibson, Get Certified, Get Ahead. He has 75 pre-assessment tests, 75 post-assessment tests, and 165 chapter assessment question. Final thing I will tell you about this is you can also get supplementary materials like flashcards, cheat sheets. ChatGPT and Claude can actually be a good resource that you can prompt these LLMs to train you for the exam. Okay, now let's talk about the key focus areas. The hardest domain to me is cryptography. For some reason, those concepts were just a little bit different that I had to study over and over again to grasp the concept. Some of the commonly appearing concepts on the exam that is very important for you to know are 1, CIA. That is the bedrock of cybersecurity. That is confidentiality, integrity, and availability. The access controls, threats, threat actors, vulnerability, and mitigation. The exam day experience. When I took the exam, I forgot my eyeglasses in the car because I don't use my eyeglasses to drive. I just left it there. So don't forget your eyeglasses. That's the first. I took the exam at a test center. I just think it's easy for me to just focus on the exam strictly and not do it at home. So if your exam is less than 45, if your exam test center is less than 45 minutes, I will advise you to take it at the test center. So you are not concerned about your internet going away and you're not concerned about the scrutiny for you to show all around the room because they want to make sure that you are not. The ID that you need a driver's license and you need a secondary form of ID. It could be your credit card. I went with my driver's license. I went with my passport. I went with a credit card. I went with everything I could go with so that anything cannot go wrong. time management during the exam. If there are any questions that you cannot answer in 40 seconds, flag the question. You want to make sure that you get to all the questions. Then towards the end, you can now go to the questions that you flagged. This way, you are confident that you have the time to get to all the questions. You don't want to waste too much time answering one question. Then at the end of the day, you realize that you don't have enough time to solve all the questions. The type of questions are two: performance-based questions and the normal multiple choice questions. Performance-based questions that I got were three, and it was just very ambiguous for me. I just couldn't figure it out. I'm very sure that I flunked and I still performed well. This means that the performance-based questions is not as important as CompTIA makes you feel it is. You can fail everything and still pass the exam. The other questions are normal multiple choice questions. To me, they were very straightforward. The questions were not lengthy at all. They were direct. The process I used was that when I see the questions, I try to eliminate two wrong choices. If I don't know it directly, I eliminate two wrong choices. Then I just try to now dissect those two choices that are correct further. So when I dissect it, eventually I get the correct answer. And even when I don't get the correct answer, that means I have the 50% chance of getting the questions right, unlike when I first started that it was only a 25% chance. If you really want to study for the performance-based question, there's something on YouTube that is Cybercraft. If you just type in Cybercraft Security Plus on YouTube, there's a YouTube channel that will bring you all the resources for the performance-based question. Another important resource that you can use is that CompTIA has a mobile app that is very useful. They have so many questions that test you on different part of the exam. And they have the option of a paid app. You really don't need the paid app because the questions are there on the free app. To summarize and conclude this video, one thing I want to tell you is that you can do it. Getting the Security Plus can literally change your career direction. Because if you want to go into GovTech, the basic requirement to enter is getting the Security Plus. And I think your decision to pass this exam will be very handy and very important. One is that I'll be having a series in which I'll be going through 10 questions each for the 28 exam domain. And I'll be going through the questions and I'll be taking you through how I reason through the questions. And I believe that this will really aid you. I will link this somewhere below and you can go chapter by chapter through the 28 chapters or objective, and it will help you out a lot. Make sure you comment below. You can ask questions. I'll be right there to answer all the questions. And if there's anything I don't know, I'll be willing to do the research and get back to you. So comment below anything you have. What will I do differently? One thing I'll do differently is that I will schedule the exam immediately when I start studying. If you're watching this video and you want to take the CompTIA Security Plus 701 exam and you want to pass as soon as possible, schedule the exam today and schedule it 45 days out. So that means that that's 6 weeks. So even if you don't know anything about cybersecurity, you can maybe buy a book or go online and just study for 6 weeks and go take the exam. The second thing is that the most important thing is getting 750. If you get 900 and another person gets 750, they will still get the certificate. Okay, that is the most important thing. Getting 900 doesn't really matter. Just pass the exam. That's what matters. Another thing is that use all the time allotted to you. You want to make sure that if you are given 90 minutes to take the exam, use 90 minutes. Even if you finish early and you have 20 minutes to spare, you want to go through all the questions again, because just spend the extra time, right? Nobody is chasing you. Wait in the exam and go through all the exam again and make sure that you didn't make any. Avoid drinking too much water before going to take the exam. Drinking too much water or any fluid, you might need to go to the bathroom. And you want to take this exam 90 minutes stretch without going to the bathroom. Because if you go to the bathroom, you might lose like 5 minutes. So try and make sure you don't drink as much water before doing the exam. Another thing in this CompTIA exam is that memorization will not help you that much. These questions are practical based questions that if you're spending all your time to memorize and you are not understanding the concept, you are doing yourself a disservice. Just understand the concept, go to the exam and try not to memorize. Now, if you want to memorize, memorize a day or two before the exam so that they will still be in your memory, the things that you've memorized. If you decide to use Udemy and you are seeing a price of $90, $100 for a course, just put it in your cart. Anything that you want to do, put it in your cart. Those, they go on sale eventually. Don't spend more than $15 for any resource on Udemy. Just put it in your cart, then you'll see a sale going on, and buy during the sale. You'll be surprised that a lot of employers actually pay for this exam. Go to your company and make sure that you don't have the resource for the company to pay before paying for the exam. A lot of companies, they pay for this exam, and it makes sense to just ask your supervisor if the company can cover it. Also, a lot of company pays for Udemy, right? So you can just get the Udemy free. So to conclude this summary, the most important thing is that get yourself ready for the exam and try and focus on this exam within 45 days to pass. There will be a lot of practice exam series that I'll be doing over the next month or two that will be on YouTube that you can definitely benefit from. You can do it. I believe in you. Go and get this exam done.